more time.
Amen.
Amen. How he has brought us together one more time.
Amen.
Amen. We thank you, God, for, amen, that he has given us life, life, health, and strength. Amen. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen. And that we're moving, we're going. Hallelujah. Moving to and fro. Amen. Doing the will of the Lord. Amen. We'd like you to, amen, heed the announcements. Some of the announcements have been made. Some of them, amen, have been made that I didn't know I was supposed to be at. Amen. But God is good. The Bible says your gift will make room for you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Now, that's a true statement coming from the Word of God, whether you're ready for it or not.
Amen.
It just said, be ye also
ready.
I can't get no help in here.
Ready.
It said, be ye also
ready.
Now, the thing about it is, we need to get ready.
Amen.
People don't want to get ready. We're going through transitions trying to get ready. Some of us are moving, want to get, amen, ready and can't. Some of us are ready, no place to go. Everybody's at different stages, amen.
Amen.
Different places in life and different places in your Christian walk. We are at different places, amen, in this church. But God, amen, has also called us to operate in the fivefold ministries in the kingdom of God. So it does not matter where you are, amen, in your walk with Christ, the thing that God wants you to understand that you need to keep on looking forward and keep moving. Amen?
Amen.
If you're running, keep moving forward. Tell somebody, if you're running, keep moving forward. If you're walking, keep moving forward. If you have to crawl, keep moving forward. Amen. Come on, put your hands together and give God praise. Amen. This is Brandon Green from Emmanuel Temple Holiness Church. Amen. Where I am the senior pastor. Amen. Pastor Christopher Steele for those on YouTube. Amen. My address is 798 West Pine Circle, Statesville, North Carolina. Amen. There may be somebody out there that want to send a donation because they were touched by the word of God that's being preached out of this ministry.
Amen.
Amen. You have several different ministers in the house. Amen. You can give all seven of them one scripture to preach from. Every last one of them should have a different revelation from God in some portion of that scripture. The scripture don't change. The word don't change. It's immutable. God's word is the same. But God gives, amen, revelations.
Amen.
He gives higher heights and deeper depths of his revelation and his word. And we want to, amen, just reiterate some of the things that our bishop is, amen, talking. He's trying to get the pastors to come together more. He's trying to, amen, unify the body and restructure the body, amen, of the TPC to try to get us at a place of growth. Somebody say growth.
Growth.
Growth is very difficult at times. Growth, amen, comes whether you're ready for it or not.
Amen.
Growth is going to occur, amen, with time. Time never stands still. It's slow, but it never stands still. It keeps moving. To some of us, amen, that statement is not true. Because for some of us, time is very swift. Time is very quick. Amen. The problem is, it just depends on where you are and what you're going through. For some of us that got everything in order and everything in place, time slows down because we got everything together. Amen. And time is just creeping along and we're ahead of time. We're ahead of our schedule. I can't get no help in here. We're ahead of what we're supposed to be doing. We're ahead of where, amen, our plans are. If you don't have any plans, you automatically plan to fail. Some of us have made plans, amen. I got a book where I keep my finances in order. And I got what I'm going to pay when. And when I do what my planning book says, I found out that I'm waiting for the next paycheck. Amen. The paycheck has come, amen, in the bank. And because I got everything lined up, amen, I sometimes forget what day it is. But when you don't have things in place, when you don't pay your bills, when you go out and have a good time and buy stuff instead of paying your bills, I'm talking to somebody right there.
Amen.
When you done took your money and you done wasted it, amen, you're waiting on the next paycheck. Hallelujah. You don't know where it's going to come from. And you got, you run out of food. And you need some more food. And you, hallelujah. I teach my boy. I say, son, people will have a good time on their money.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll come and ask you to borrow your money to pay your bills.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. I would say that again. I told my brother, no. Sometimes you just got to say,
no.
But all conviction in your heart, you just got to say,
no.
Amen. Some of y'all ain't saying, I'm trying to get y'all to say, hallelujah. Sometimes you just got to look them in the face and say,
no.
Amen. Hallelujah. Just say no. Just say no. Amen. Just say no. If you would, don't mind, turn with me to the book of Ezekiel. Amen. 47th chapter, starting at the first verse. And I just want to, amen, reiterate what our prelate, Bishop T.O. Carter, preached last Sunday.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And just bringing you up to date to where our theme was for our convocation. If you haven't said amen,
amen.
We're waiting. Ezekiel, it's in the Old Testament, the 47th chapter, starting at the first verse. Ezekiel, the 47th chapter, starting at the first verse. Amen. It's talking about the millennial reign. There's going to come a time when everything you see, amen, around you, as far as the trees, the grass, amen, life as we know it, it's all going to change. Amen. Everything is going to change. Hallelujah. It's called the millennial reign of Christ Jesus. And this is one of the things that's going to happen in the millennial reign. Amen. Do you have it? Say amen.
Amen.
It reads as does. Afterward, he brought me again unto the door of the house. And behold, waters issued out from under the threshold of the house eastward. For the forefront of the house stood toward the east, and the waters came down from under the right side of the house, at the south side of the altar. Then brought he me out of the way of the gate northward, and led me toward the way without unto the utter gate by the way that looketh eastward, and behold, there ran out waters on the right side. And when the man that had the line in his hand went forth eastward, he measured 1,000 cubits, and he brought me through the waters. The waters were to the ankles. And he measured 1,000 and brought me through the waters. The waters were to the knees. Again he measured 1,000 and brought me through. The waters were to the loins. Afterward he measured 1,000, and it was a river that I could not pass over, for the waters were risen, waters to swim in, a river that could not be passed over. And he said unto me, Son of man, hast thou seen this? Then he brought me and caused me to return to the brink of the river. Now when I had returned, behold, at the bank of the river were very many trees on one side and on the other. Then said he unto me, these waters issue out toward the east country, and go down into the desert, and go into the sea, which being brought forth into the sea, the waters shall be healed. And it came to pass, and it shall come to pass, that everything that liveth, that which moveth, whithersoever the river shall come, shall live. And there shall be a very great multitude of fish, because these waters shall come together. For they shall be healed, and everything shall live, whether the water, the river, cometh. Father, in Jesus' name, give us wisdom and understanding to preach your word for this congregation, for this hour, for this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I would like to use, amen, the same subject that our bishop used. Amen. I believe he said, I'm in over my head. Amen. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. In case you didn't know it, it's time
to get in
over your head. Come on and put your hands together and give God praise. It's a we see that the prophet Ezekiel was given a vision. And he was given many visions. Amen. But this portion of the 47th chapter of Ezekiel speaks about the river that issued out of the sanctuary. Amen. The place, the house of God. Amen. A river that ran down. Amen. When it ran down, it ran eastward. And it had a purpose. It was going eastward. Amen. For the purpose of God's will. And that will is to heal. God said that anywhere that these waters would flow, there would be healing. Amen. Rivers of living water right now is what God said the Holy Spirit would be. But there is going to be a river that flows out of the sanctuary in the millennial reign. Amen. That's going to bring natural healing. Amen.
Amen.
In this river, amen, we see that the prophet Ezekiel, amen, was carried through the threshold of the sanctuary. The description, amen, of the significance of the sanctuary, giving, amen, of new eternal laws, because everything is going to become new. Amen. The Lord showed the prophet the final thing about the sanctuary. Recorded here in this book, amen, they measured the waters. When we began to go out, amen, to follow the man that had the line, I don't know if it was Jesus himself or if it was an angel, they began to step out and they began to walk through different areas, amen, and through different gates. And when they began to walk, the man took a line and he measured 1,000 cubits, hallelujah, about 2,083 feet. And he said that the waters came up around his ankles, and, amen. The waters being around your ankles, amen. Some of us right now, as we go through difficult times, amen, it's one thing when water is over your head and water is at your ankles. We had a lot of rain here just recently, and some of the people that I see on TV, amen, they were wading out in waters that were around their ankles, but some of them was wading in waters, amen, around the knees. And the Bible says, amen, that he measured 1,000 more cubits, and the water come up, amen, about the knees. When we get in water that comes about our knees, we get a little bit worried. If you go, hallelujah, anywhere into a river, water is going, coming up around your knees, amen, it began to move you a little bit. Just take a trip down to the beach, amen, and you'll see that. When you wade out in the waters that's up around your knees, you find out that it's pretty soothing, it's pretty comfortable. Because the waves go out, and the waves come in. The waves go out, and the waves come in.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I did not notice, but when I went back to my hotel, the man on TV gave out a warning. He said, if you go out in water up to your waist, there are subcurrents that can pull you out in the ocean. And they can drag you out to the deep part of the ocean. And you can drown. And I didn't know it, but I was wading out in the water, amen, that was up to my waist and up to my chest. And I said, this ain't so bad. Hallelujah. One time when I was out there, amen, swimming around and floating around, I seen, amen, one of those things that come, one of those, what you call, jellyfish. It came about 2 or 3 feet away from me. I was fine as long as I didn't see it. But when I saw it, I panicked. Hallelujah. When you get out of water that's deep that you can't, amen, succumb to, you can't control, sometimes we panic. Life brings forth, amen, problems that brings us into places where we're ankle deep. When problems come, amen, and we're ankle deep in those problems, that's fine. Hallelujah. Sometimes we get in problems that come, amen, knee high. Some of us, amen, right now I know on my job there was a great explosion and some of the people, they just bought cars. Some just bought houses and they were calling one another and they were saying, my God, what are we going to do? Have you heard any more news? The main part, the main machine, the heart of our company, the machine that is the heart of our company, blew up, amen. It's going to take about 3 months to repair that, boy. But they're going to try to work around the clock, and they're going to try to work as hard as they can to get it done in 2 months. And we're going to be working 7 days a week, and the people told the people, ensured the people that they wouldn't get laid off. And we're going to go to the point to find other companies out there that have the same product that we have. But we're not going to give them our secret, because what we use, secrets. Glory, hallelujah. I'm going somewhere with this. And when they told the people, don't be worried, we're not going to lay you off, amen. Because the amen, laws that when you get laid off, the laws of unemployment just change. Somebody said it just changed. God, they just cut it from 26 weeks now to 20 weeks. You can only draw for 20 weeks now. If you made $120,000 a year for the last 10 years and you got laid off your job in the old system, they will give you more money than a person making $20,000 a year. But now they are changing things that the only up, the highest amount you can get is about $350. When you can make $150,000 a year, you can't make it on $350 a month, a week. I think it's going to help you here. You let some waters up to your waist, hallelujah. And the people begin to worry, and they begin to wonder, what in the world are we going to do? And they secure the people's minds and told them, don't worry about nothing. We got everything under control. We're doing this. We're doing that. We're doing things to try and to make sure everybody is working.
The prophet began to look, and I believe in the sixth verse. He said, the man caused me to come back to the brink of the river. I don't care how deep the river is, whatever your problem may be, God said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. He'll always hold your hand. When the man of God, as Ezekiel was looking at him, measured out, and then he brought him back to the brink. When he come back to the brink of the river, he began to look at the things that were around the river. Saints, what I'm trying to say is open your eyes and see what is going on.
Amen.
Open your eyes in your community and see what's happening.
Amen.
The rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer.
Yeah.
I was reading in the other day that we are a farming state. And as long as the farmers are producing, amen, they're going to have money generated. On the other side of the political scheme, when they see that they were, amen, giving money and subsidies out to farmers, they somehow attached food stamps to the farm subsidies. So that the farming and the food stamps go hand in hand. They splitting that up now. Hallelujah. They started to pass, amen, the proliferation again to give the farmers subsidies, but they did not let it pass this time. Why did they not let it pass? There's a young man on my job that works with me. He's a farmer. He said, right now, they done this. I just found out that when you go to buy your seed, they done genetically engineered the corn. They done genetically engineered the soybeans. They done genetically engineered everything that when you go buy it, they know how many bushels you buy. And when you take that, what you have bought, and plant it on your land, they take the time from a satellite to see how much seed you bought versus how much land you have. And if you don't plant all the seed you bought, they're going to, amen, come and take the money of the subsidies that they give you, take it back. From a satellite, they look and see how much land you have versus how much seed you bought and how much yield that you produce. And if you have any left over, they're going to come knocking at your door. They're going to come down to a science to know exactly how many seeds you got left. I'm going to help you here. They're selling machines now that have a GPS in them. All you have to do is just get in the tractor, load your tractor up with the seeds, turn the switch, amen, put your feet on the, amen, accelerator, and set back with your arms folded. The machine will do all the work.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's guided from a satellite over 1,500 miles in the sky. And it tells that machine exactly where to go, what to go around, you program it in, and it plant all the seeds for you. Got it down to a science that that thing will plant the seeds 2 inches, 3 inches, 4 inches, whatever you set it from each other, and make sure a seed is in every hole. Hallelujah. So that when you bring forth a yield, you know they paid to buy the farmer just to plant so much. They pay them not sometimes. Sometimes they pay them not to plant anything at all.
Amen.
They manipulate the growth, amen, of the crops in our state so that now anybody on food stamps, because I believe they was given $78 billion worth of food stamps out per year. Subsidies that are going out to, they're going to give $78 billion each year. But they say all these people, amen, should not be on all of this. I can't even know that way. And things are changing so, amen, they're not going to stop at food stamps. church.
Yes,
it's time to commit our hearts and our lives to God. It's time, amen, to lay aside every burden. God's been telling us all this time. I've been preaching. Lay it aside, lay it aside.
Yes.
Lay it aside.
Yes, God.
The weights and the sins we do it so easily to set us. Because the world is changing. Jesus is soon to come. You've been hearing this, amen, all your life, ever since you were born. But your life is about that long when it comes to eternity.
Yes, amen.
The 70 years you've been living, that's all it is.
Amen.
The 50 years I've been living, that's how long it takes. That's 50 years right there. I ain't got to snap my finger 50 years ago.
Amen.
When it comes to eternity, we're talking about the millennial reign. He said that when he brought me back to the ring. Amen. In this time, everything is going to be changed and the rivers are going to go, amen, and heal. The rivers come out of the sanctuary and went down toward the east. Went down toward the Red Sea. The Dead Sea, excuse me. And when it reached the Dead Sea, the Bible said it healed the waters of the Dead Sea. And when it got to Jerusalem, the river split. One went to the Mediterranean Sea, one went to the Dead Sea, and everywhere the waters went, everything was healed.
Yes, sir.
He said he looked at the trees when he come back to the grave, and the trees, amen, yielded fruit every month. It did not, amen, stop yielding fruit every month. January, I looked at the trees and they had fruit on them. February, I looked at the trees and they had fruit on them. Somebody gave me the water. Cast their net to pull out great amounts of fish. God is trying to get us ready for something new. There's going to be a change. He's going to come back again. It ain't going to happen in this time right here. It ain't going to happen in this time right here. It ain't going to, look at somebody and say, it ain't going to happen.
In this time.
Right here.
He's
going to come back again. And then change is going to take place. So the thing that we need to do is change according to the Word.
Yeah.
So that when we do come back, we'll find ourselves in the Word.
Yeah.
Time to get it over your head, saints.
Yeah.
When God comes back, if you're in His Word, amen, and His Word is in you, He's going to spare your life.
Yeah.
But if you don't, you're going to go through a great tribulation. You're going to go through many troubles. Hallelujah. He's coming back in the twinkling of an eye. I don't care how society's changed. I don't care how many theologians come forth. I don't care how many new ideas they get. The Bible says He's coming back in the middle of the sky.
Yeah.
And the great trumpet of God shall sound.
Yeah.
The dead in Christ shall rise first.
Yeah.
Those of us that remain, that are saved, shall be caught up to be here in the air.
Yeah.
There is no way anybody else can make it because it's going to be in a twinkling of an eye. Amen. Somebody said, blink your eye. Amen. Blink your eye. That ain't what it's talking about. It's talking about a twinkling of an eye. Amen. Your eye twitches so fast you don't even know it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yo, when you're sleeping at night, your eyes are twitching. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. He's coming back so fast that we're going to be gone. Nobody will be able to get ready. And then the great tribulation is coming. And when He comes back, the millennial reign, a 1,000-year reign. Amen. He's going to shut the devil up in the bottomless pit. And He's going to reign on the earth for 1,000 years. And then He's going to loose after the 1,000 years. He's going to loose. Amen. Say, because everybody, just like now in this time, in the millennial reign, everybody ain't going to want to do what God said. God is telling you, come to the altar. Give your heart to me. I'll save you. I am the bread of life. Take of me, you'll never thirst. And when it rain, people are going to come to the sanctuary to sacrifice. But they ain't going to have a heart to sacrifice. He's going to lose the devil. He's going to go out and he's going to get everyone that really don't agree with Christ. And they're going to raise up an army to fight against Christ.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And then he's going to come back again. And the Bible says, the sword shall go out of his mouth. Yes. Amen. It is the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. When you get in over your head, God will let you see things that nobody else can see.
Amen.
I'm prophesying right now. Amen. I believe one of the prophets, amen, when the city was being besieged by the enemy, the people of the city looked up and seen the enemy on the mountains, everywhere, getting ready to destroy the city. The prophet stood there calm, cool, and collected. His apprentice standing beside him said, "Man, what is wrong with you? We're getting ready to die. We're getting ready to die. You just cool, calm, and collected." He looked over and said, "Lord, let him see what I see."
Amen.
God opened him the apprentice's eyes. And then when he looked up that last time, he not only seen the enemies getting ready to take the city, but he seen the angels of God standing behind the enemy. And when the enemy moved to kill the city, the angels killed the enemy. This is what God is allowing us to see. This is what allowing your leaders to see. This is what co-pastor and I see. We see what God is trying to take us. Correction. We see what God is taking us. And whether you get on board or not, that's up to you. You can get in the way. You can get out of the way. You can get left behind.
Amen.
But God's kingdom will be promoted. Amen?
Amen.
Without me, God's kingdom is going to be promoted.
Amen.
I ain't nobody.
Amen.
Amen. God's will is going to take place. Amen. Regardless of what we think.
Amen.
How we, what we say and what we do.
Amen.
The thing he's trying to get us, amen, to understand is we need to find ourselves in his word.
Amen.
It's time to get in over our head, saints. If you don't get in over your head in Christ, then you're going to find yourself over your head, amen, in the world.
Amen.
The devil is going to come, and his job is to steal, kill, and destroy.
Amen.
That's taking place right now in your life, whether you believe it or not.
Amen.
Situations and circumstances, amen, in your life, where you're supposed to be prospering, you want to buy, you ain't prospering. The devil, amen, has got stuff on you. There's a curse on you. There's something in you. Amen. Hallelujah. That's causing prosperity not to come your way. God said, if you do my will, my blessings will overtake you. But the blessings are standing back looking at you. You wonder why things ain't happening in your life. Amen. I'm prophesying on somebody right now. We thank God for our visitors. Amen. Thank God for these young men. Come on. Put your hands up. Thank God for all the younger son and the younger son. Amen. God bless you, sir.
Amen.
Thank God for these young men. Thank God for you. Our
business.
Just want to let you know, hallelujah, that you are part of the prophecy that I spoke a long time ago. Folks in here has been coming to church for years and years and years. In the way, don't want to do nothing.
Jesus.
Don't want to get right. Don't want to walk right. Don't want to do nothing. God's going to bring some folks outside. He's going to bring them up in this church. Fill this church. And because you don't want to do it, he's going to take the gift from you and give it to them. Talk about it if you want to. Oh, she's a prostitute. He's a dog slayer. God can use anybody he wants to. He can change her, amen, and use her for his glory.
Hallelujah.
God's kingdom is going to be promoted.
Amen.
I can't reach everybody. God and that minister must come out of this church to go, amen, and reach other souls.
Amen.
We can only go so far. Our hearts are only so long.
Amen.
But God can use, amen, others, amen, to go out.
Yes. Amen.
There's going to be ministers that come up out of this ministry.
Amen.
There may be preachers that come up out of this ministry, pastors, evangelists that come up out of this ministry. Because God, amen, has got to get his program across. Church, it's time to get it on your head. Time to get, amen, deep in the waters. It's time to let God, amen, have control of your whole life, not just some of it.
You've been hearing folks a half saved. Ain't such thing as a half saved person.
Amen.
Either you're saved or not. Amen. Hallelujah. There is no middle ground, no way. Either you're saved or you're not. Thank you. I talk to you and I appeal, amen, to your consciousness that it is time for us, amen, regardless of what, amen, you're going through right now. God is still on the throne.
Amen.
He's still God.
Amen.
His word is still true.
Amen.
Regardless of what happened in your past. Some of us may be mad at God for taking our mom, taking our daddy, or causing us to come up, amen, have to be moved to live with our aunt or our uncle that may have, amen, misused us. You got to forget that stuff.
Amen.
Get your past in the past.
Amen.
God said when you step out in the waters, I'll take you as deep as you want to go.
Yeah.
Oh, my shine. Thank you, Holy Ghost. He said, I'll take you as deep as you want to go. If you just want to go ankle deep, you'll just get an ankle deep blessing.
Yeah.
If you want to go knee deep, you'll get a knee deep blessing. If you want to go waist deep, you'll get a waist deep blessing, and that's all you'll ever get. But if you want to go right over your head,
yes.
He said, I'll make ways for you. I'll open doors for you. I'll make your enemy, oh, shall become your footstool. He said, I heal your body to cause sickness, amen, to get away from you. I won't let your fruit be cast away before the time when you obey, amen, the blessing of the time. He said, in the new millennium, there's going to be new laws given. If you can't follow the laws now, how in the world are you going to follow the laws in the new millennium? And let me say that again. So now, if you can't follow what God's word says now, when you get a new word, how in the world are you going to be able to follow it? Because the things that apply now won't apply when Jesus comes and we operate the new millennium. The Bible says that his name is, what's his name? Jesus. He is, amen, the Savior of our sins. They shall call his name, amen, Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Prince of Peace. But after all is said and done, through the tribulation, through the millennium, it said he's coming back again on a white horse. He said on his vesture is going to be a new name. A name that no man can name. A name that the angels can't name. Amen. His name is not going to be Jesus anymore.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. The devil got to get
up
my mouth.
Amen.
He's going to come. He's going to come.
Yes.
He's going to come.
Amen.
Y'all just see that.
Amen.
He just come.
Amen. God let me see him. Knock him off.
He did now. Hallelujah. That's exactly what God's doing. He'll bless you even when your enemies, people you don't even know, that you think they're your friends, trying to pull you down. God will spare your life and make them enemies your footstool. Hallelujah. Hope you got something out of the word today.